for Duke, Mike, is they haven't been able to get good shots. They came out of that last time out ahead by 8, and the first thing they did was turn it over twice, and they've never really recovered.
Got the numbers here. Lang's going to have to price for 3. And when the open shots don't go, Maryland can get its transition game going. Patty Watt.
Well, Mike, one of the things that Maryland's going to do to you, that press isn't necessarily to steal the ball, but it speeds up the game. So, yeah, you're going to shoot some of those open threes, but Duke as a team in ACC competition hits only 34% of its three-point shots. So a lot of times they're going to miss, and you've got a transition game going the other way.
And when Billy Tubbs was at Oklahoma, he used to say, I don't care if they score, just as long as they shoot it fast and we get it back. .427 to go first half. Tied at 36. Parks, nice position inside. He's fouled by Booth. That's 2 on Booth.
That Duke inside game can create problems. Parks does a great job getting position. Lucas doesn't really battle him very hard in there. What a great step through on that pick. You just got to battle harder than that against Cherokee Park.
Well, if you don't, it's just ain't you alive. Pretty good at directing traffic, too. 6 points, 5 boards. What would you expect from somebody named Chief?
That's right.
A very unselfish leader of the tribe, however. Joe Smith, after a very brief respite, back in. Seen a rugby game? That is a scrum.
All we need is some mud.
Maryland basketball. Yes, the Cabbage with number 13 is in for the first time. From now on, we will refer to him by his first name as Sarunas. Foul inside. This is going to be a hold on Tony Moore, just checked in.
A horrible thing. You're sitting there on the bench and the coach says go in the game and you're really excited about it, but they send you in to guard the other guy's best player.
This sounds like experience talking.
Absolutely. You're always very excited to get in the game. However.
Rodney Elliott, who's in for the first time, gets a free throw and misses it. Parks with another rebound. The Chief has 6 in the first half.
An extra hip matched up against Jeff Capel. This just shows you the versatility of hip. He can get out there and guard somebody at the point. Now he's got a traveling violation against Price and another Duke turnover. Early they weren't turning over at all. Now they've got 6.
3:39 to go first half. Duke with a 3-point lead over Maryland. By 3 with 3:39 to go first half. The ACC just loaded with interior talent this year. Joe Smith, second in the ACC in scoring, rebounding, and field goal percentage. Cherokee Park for Duke, third in both scoring and rebounding. Over to North Carolina for Rasheed Wallace. He leads the ACC in field goal percentage. He's second in blocks. The leading shot blocker is Tim Duncan, also leads the ACC in rebound. And Todd Fuller at NC State, second in the Atlantic Coast Conference with 12 double-doubles this year. Quite a collection, isn't it?
It is a collection unrivaled, probably. There's Jeff the Cabbage is banking it home. Tonight in this drains the 3. His nickname is Shooter. Well, that's the shooter's touch right there. Often when the ball bounces around the rim, they say it's the shooter's touch. But more appropriate, I think, is when you bank one in from the top of the key.
Tied at 39. More offensive rebound. Maryland with a chance to regain the lead. Simpkins pushes it. Can't hit the shot. Loose ball Park. 3-on-1. Price mishandled the ball and puts it up on the right side. Terrible execution for Duke on a 3-on-1 fast break.
Mike, you shouldn't be settling for an off-balance jumper on a 3-on-1, that's for sure.
Yeah. gets it low to Smith. Great move to get by Park. Just blew by him. It was strength that got himself in that position, Mike. He used his strength to get great position, and then that explosiveness really came to the fore. 17 points for Joe Smith in the first half. Painful baseline. Park. 41. Cherokee with 9. Vikings for the Blue Devils. I really think if they're going to win the game, they're going to have to shoot the ball very well. Well, they started beautifully and then had the problems in the middle, started turning it over. Talking about the big game that Joe Smith is having tonight. Watch Joe Smith get down in position in here. Cherokee Park's now, he feels Park going to the baseline. He sets himself up the other direction, catches the ball, and just explodes to the basket.
Well, you have to feel the first game was an anomaly for Joe Smith. 6 points and 5 rebounds. Look what he has in a half tonight. The runner by Langdon. And Smith went down hard. 9 for Trajan Langdon.
Very, very hot in here. Joe Smith walking slowly back up the court.
Well, he's had a whole night's worth of work here in the first half.
Speaking of people who've had a whole night's worth of work in the first half.
Kovarik and Yesakavich is the backcourt now for Maryland. The lob down low for Lucas. Tries to power it up against Park. Here's Capel. Again, an advantage for Duke on the break, and they couldn't get anything out of it. Nearly taken away by Kovarik. And a bad pass by Capel. A bounce pass that was sort of a short hop at Blakeney. 7 turnovers against the Blue Devils.
Cherokee Park, the second all-time leading shot blocker at Duke. And he's been swatting them away tonight. 5 in the first half.
Only needs 120 to get Mike Jaminski in the next 5-6 games. Nice give and go, nice dish off to Smith, leans in for one, can't hit it.
That's great hustle by Kovarik.
But he slid the pivot, put it at the baseline.
Number 4.
Coming up on our Delta Boston halftime report, Chris Fowler and Digger Phelps in the studio. Who's on the bubble and what phrase can we use to replace on the bubble? ACC update of the numbers on Kurt Thomas tonight.
We've got 45 seconds left in the first half.
This has been a beauty, hasn't it?
It's really been an offensive display here. And with all the offense, you know, Cherokee Park's on the defensive end. 5 block shots, that's his season high.
Blakeney bringing it up to Price. 10-second difference on the shot clock and game clock. Excuse me, Dan.
You've had guys making plays, Mike. And that's when you have exciting basketball games, and people make plays like that.
Blocked by Joe Smith. The lob to him. Can't quite make the catch. I think the only guy who can do that was here last year.
We talked about Cherokee Parks on the defensive end with his block shots. Joe Smith does a great job. Mike, you see how he put his hands straight up in the air? There was contact, but it was basically Cherokee Park putting his arms into Joe Smith's face. Smith did not drop that arm, and so he gets the block.
Duke playing for the last shot. Parks for 3. Hip has it at the buzzer. Good offensive display by both ball clubs in the first half. Joe Smith just had a sensational effort with 17 points and 9 boards in the first 20 minutes. And Billy Hahn, with his chance to coach Maryland as the head coach for the first time this year, sees his club down by 2. Back at Duke, where the Blue Devils are leading Maryland 43-41. We've talked to you about the great collection of big men in the ACC this year. So we have Joe Smith and Cherokee Park to analyze each other.
He's stepping out, seeing the jumper. He can take the ball off the dribble. I mean, he can take it to the hole off the dribble.
Thank you.
got a variety of moves, and look to guard him out to about 17 feet, and he's always going to the board. So he's just a player, maybe you always got to have an awareness for him.
A comparison of what they did in the first half. Joe Smith, just an incredible first half performance. 17 points, 10 boards and a block. Cherokee, not bad either. 9 points, 6 rebounds, and 5 block shots and a half.
Just all in a day's work. You know, the problem for Joe Smith and the Terps, Mike, is that nobody else is close for Maryland. The next highest scorer has 6 points.
Parks will try baseline jumper and come up short. Hit for the long outlet pass to Smith, and he is fouled immediately by Blakely.
Duke a little slow. Joe Smith with a laugh there. He knew he had a dunk. If he just catch the ball and go to the basket, he's got a dunk.
That smile shows you one of the great things about that young man. He just enjoys the game so much. Doesn't wolf at other players. Doesn't give you any of the hot dog stuff. Just plays.
Well, I agree with you, Mike, but you would enjoy it, too, if you had 17 points and 10 rebounds in the first half.
The lob to hit. Great defense by Blakeney to get in his way and tip the ball. With excellent awareness. Langdon. Capel. Tough side channel shot. Got the roll.
You know, that side channel shot off the drive, that's really Capel's shot. It looks like a tough shot, but that's what he makes consistently.
Johnny Rhodes in deep answer for Maryland. Cuts the lead back to 2.
Got to be aware of Rhodes down on the inside. The big guys have to come over and help.
Rhodes now has 6 in the game. Parks lost it on the way in. Smith, contact, blocking.
And that's an excellent call on the fast break. You know, if you're Dwayne Simpkins, you're one of the ACC's top point guards, you can certainly enhance your reputation by finding number 32 on the break.
In the first half, both teams shooting over 40%, free throws about even. Duke with an edge with 2 more 3-point field goals. The rebounding story, 4 from Maryland. And points in the paint, the Terps with an edge there.
Well, of course, Joe Smith has been such a big factor on the inside.
Smith has hit 4 of his 5 free throws tonight.
Particularly early in the half, Mike, in the first half, Duke was able to make a high percentage of its shots, and I really think that's what they have to do in this basketball game. I don't think they're going to shut off Maryland defensively. They've got to make the plays on the offensive end.
Tied at 45, they beat the press again, but Maryland hustles back, and Blayton can't do anything with it. Parks.
Oh, what a move.
Shot wouldn't fall for him, and Smith with another rebound. Pretty good job by Booth. The pass, Meek knocks it away, but Maryland retains possession.
You know, I think if Meek doesn't get his hand on that ball, it goes into about the 5th row.
Smith over Parks. Tough shot. I mean, Cherokee Parks is a tremendous interior defensive player. That's 21 points for Joe Smith.
But if Joe Smith is going to get position, and when he has position, Mike, his teammates are going to get him the ball. He's so quick with it in there, you don't have time to drop down and help out again.
Maryland with a 2-point lead. Meek wants the ball in deep against Smith. They'd like to pick up another foul on him. Langdon, in and out. Parks, and it's partially blocked. Smith with another rebound.
Every hit from 6'7" can be effective in there blocking shots.
Simpkins with a lob, and again it was Meek knocking it away. Great defense by
Duke.
Joe Smith is awfully tough to guard inside. Watch how quickly he gets position here. He's going to set himself up. Watch how quickly he gets the ball once he asks for it, and then he just turns and shoots it. You can't help out against that. But I'll tell you what, that has an awful lot to do with guard play. The guard has to find the guy open like that to create that kind of an opportunity.
And Simpkins has been very, very good at it. Blakeney for 3. Smith with another rebound. 13-4 already for Joe Smith to go with 21 points.
Nobody's guarding him.
Makes the 3. X-3 Hip, who's a 31% long-range shooter. after Maryland makes the run to go up by five, filling in for Gary Williams, who's hospitalized with pneumonia after having a tough bout with the flu, but he's supposed to be out for the hospital by the end of the week.
And we certainly wish Gary the best, and you know why the head coach's seat is called the hot seat, because you look like Billy Hahn after coaching for a half. He's probably going to have about four rows on the bus all to himself.
And he's going to be about 20 pounds lighter than when he came in the building tonight.
Man-to-man for the Terps. Duke trying to create some room on the side, and they do, and Price just blows right by.
Beautiful drive by Price. He has five.
But once again, we see that there's a sort of a chink in that Maryland armor. They're not very good one-on-one out on the basketball.
Double team on Smith. Booth gets the ball. And knocked away by Newton. And a travel on Maryland.
Joe Smith went down hard, but I'm telling you, Mike, Joe Smith did such a great job staying after that basketball. Watch Billy Hahn here. You think he's not into it? He tripped him, he's saying.
Now, look at that expression. Got to work on every call if you're going to be a coach at this level.
Well, that's right, but as an acting head coach, you know what happens? The referees ignore you.
Except in this game, because you have two acting head coaches.
Well, so they can ignore both of them.
Or pay attention to both. Here comes the pressure. Meek in the backcourt, helping out.
And Rick Hartzell just let Billy Hahn know that he was paying attention to him. Don't be quiet.
He can be a tremendous streak shooter. His first 2 points of the night. Don't be surprised the next time he touches the ball, he's got a crack at a three.
And prior to that shot, we showed you the Blue Devils only 1 of 6 in this half, Mike. That's why they've gotten behind. They've got to be able to shoot the ball well to stay in this game.
Booth. Blocked by Price. Let's see, will Price or Meek get the foul?
No, Meek is going to get the foul.
Meek? Looked like Price got him on the arm.
This is tough for Meek trying to guard Booth out on the perimeter. The help just does not come in time. You know, you're right, Mike, from the replay, they were both there. It looked like that it was possible that Price was the one who actually committed the foul, but Meek gets called for it.
And that is his fourth. So Newton is immediately up and off the bench as Keith Booth misses the free throw. And he's been so good in the last 10 games, nearly 80% from the line.
And you know, as Meek goes to the bench and Newton comes in, Meek was really an important factor in the first half, Mike, particularly on the board.
Sure was. Been tough for Booth. Has not made a field goal, missed his only free throw. Now he's 0 for 2. From the line and 0 for 5 from the floor, Maryland still leads by a point.
Mike, the Terrapins need production from Keith Booth. If he's going to struggle, the Terrapins are going to struggle. Even though Joe Smith's having the big games, the balance isn't there tonight for the Terps.
Price, great drive, the shot wouldn't fall. Kovarik with a rebound. Pushes to Smith. Too strong, the rebound, and Newton. Duke playing with a lot of confidence tonight.
Well, there's certainly no reason for the Blue Devils to be out here playing tight.
Holy cow, what range on that one? And Duke regains the lead.
Or conservatively.
Smith isolated on Newton. A lot of contact, no whistle. Tipped in by Booth. The crowd wanted an offensive foul. Maybe had a point.
Well, they got to make Joe Smith give up the ball. You just can't let him stand down in there and do all those pivots and moves.
Capel, bad pass to come. Kovar comes way out on. Collins for three. You can see If they win tonight, they would have one game remaining in the regular season. They win that, they win the ACC. And right now, we've got some security people down behind with some of the Duke students behind the Maryland bench. They have been on Billy Hahn the entire night, and I believe they're trying to remove somebody.
Now, it's one of those things where if they're trying, they'll do it.
The crowd was warned not to throw things, and apparently somebody threw some ice after that warning, and somebody is going to have to listen to this one on the radio.
Despite what it says on that guy's shirt, he's not one of ours.
No, sir. Booth with another miss from the free throw line. He has really struggled offensively tonight. 0 for 4 from the line.
You know, it's usually only the producers who throw things, and during the game, they're in the truck.
Have to take that free shirt back. Collins wants the ball. Here's a reaching foul on Booth as he stole it from Clark.
And one of the problems for Duke right now, they don't really have a point guard out there. Langdon out there, Collins out there, Maryland turning up the pressure.
And we haven't seen Wojciechowski at all.
Capel going to come back in the ball game. Price is going to go out. Collins is standing in the corner asking for the ball. There's Wojciechowski right there.
When shooters feel it, they want the ball. Capel with that side saddle shot again. He'll draw another person.
What you have to understand about Capel, Mike, is he is a scorer. And he's a guy who knows how to take the ball to the basket. And that was not a very good shot, but he drew the foul because with his athleticism, he's able to penetrate and put Maryland's defense at a disadvantage.
Accomplished his purpose. 10.6 assists. He's hit both from the line tonight.
You see there, he's got no turnover tonight. That was not a particularly good free throw.
Just got the front of the rim.
It's always better to just get the front of the rim than to miss.
You wouldn't want to bet the second one strong, which, no, it's short too. So Capel misses two tries. And the lead is two. Lucas for three. Got it.
Now, Mario Lucas has had the tendency this year to hit big three-point shots in games. And there he puts Maryland ahead. He's now got three, but that's what he does. He comes off the bench and lights it up.
He comes off firing. See if they can get Collins a good shot at the other end. Capel of Parks backing in against Booth. Missed the shot.
That shot has to go for Duke. That was a great play to get it in there. That's a shot Parks will usually make.
Smith into the lane.
Is encouraging his troops out there. Collins is back. Joe Smith runs very well in transition. That's really a tough call. It's hard to see, but the contact occurred between the torso of Joe Smith and the chest of Collins, and normally that's a charge.
Three on Smith, now a foul on Simpkins. Chris Collins isn't very emotional about this game, is he?
No. He's a fellow, obviously, very laid back. A lot like Billy Hahn, as a matter of fact.
I like to see that kind of emotion out of a young man who's making positive plays.
So now, Billy isn't all that young. Collins takes it to the basket. Draws
and
the foul.
Johnny Rhodes will get his third. Maryland getting in some foul trouble. Smith with three, Booth with three, Rhodes with three. Of course, Duke already has Eric Meek on the bench with four. But Rose, as we said before, foul trouble his entire career. He's fouled out of five games this year. There's Eric Meek. That is down with his fourth personal. He's fouled out of six this year. Collins is 75% free throw shooter. Has 6 points on the night.
He's played more minutes than usual tonight for longer stretches, and that's because his shot has been going in the basket.
And that's the double-edged sword. If a shooter can't get minutes, he can't get hot. If he's not hot, they won't give him minutes.
I wouldn't know about anything.
Duke up by a point. Hip had the fourth one, bad angle, and Newton comes out with it. Good defense by Newton and Parks.
Nobody ever stopped him, Mike. He comes spinning around there, catches.
back on top.
Duke by three, and when the Duke Blue Devils have been able to penetrate the Maryland Terrapin defense, they have had success this evening, and Collins catches the ball. Nobody catches up with him. Nobody comes to help, and Collins knocks it in the basket.
And there's a young man in real danger of using up a lifetime supply of adrenaline in one evening.
Well, if he scores very many more baskets, he's going to injure himself.
Collins with 9 points. He's hit 3 out of 4, 2 out of 2 from the line.
And one of the things that Billy Hahn probably did in that huddle was reacquaint his teammates with number 32. Johnny Rhodes draws the foul from Collins.
Joe Smith has only had 3 shots in the second half after a great first half. And we said during the timeout, you made the point, you'd think they'd just go down and keep throwing it to him, wouldn't you? Lucas leans in, can't get it. Lucas with his own rebound. Good feed to Smith over Park.
There's the idea. See, Mike, you could do this. All you need is a guy like Joe Smith. Guys, throw him the ball.
There aren't many of those around, though. Smith with 23. K-Pole with the left hand. The tip Smith by Park. Joe Smith got the foul at number 4 on Joe Smith.
Foul on Maryland.
That's huge for Maryland.
And once again, it is the penetration by the Duke guard. You get past the Maryland defense, you force people to come and help, then they're out of position, and so Cherokee Park battling inside for the rebound. Joe Smith coming over the back, but the defense had to stop the penetration.
Ball lost by Langdon. Timkins, look at how fast he is. Capel caught up, blocked the shot. It'll be 3 on Capel. Now, officially on the scoreboard, they only have 3 fouls on Joe Smith. And I have to assume that that's correct because Billy Hahn has not gotten out of the ballgame.
There you see Capel coming from behind, and he is not very happy about that particular call.
Timkins, the number one free throw shooter in the ACC, 86.1%. 7 points tonight. That was his first free throw.
Timkins just has those intense eyes. He looks like his radars are always on.
Tied at 59 with 11:43 to go in the game. Maryland regains the lead. If the Terps should lose tonight, there would be a 4-way first-place tie in the ACC. If they win tonight, they still have to play Virginia, and there could still be a 4-way tie.
The fun thing about this league, Mike, there's only one game left after tonight, and everything is still up for grabs.
Price trying to splash inside, gets it back to Langdon.
Draw the defense, pitch out for the three, Mike.
Langdon has a dozen. Timkins with the left hand puts it in. He's so quick back down court. And you can see Billy Hahn up saying to Timkins, you got